It's an eel.
You
like it?
Yeah.
It's very big.
It looks weird, don't it?
There we go. Those right there, I think you guys a little secret about the red belly. In Indiana, they're legal to own.
Aquariums,
they are chicken of humans. They will run from a human. If you stick a piece of meat down in there, they'll slowly go to it. But once you have to be careful, they're kind of a gray belly piranha. Those are vicious.
Eat anything.
They'll eat anything.
Look at these teeth in these bad
Those are a lot bigger than the ones Daddy had, aren't they?
A little bit.
A lot bigger.
Oh, wow.
Same kind, but a lot bigger.
You had really red belly piranhas?
Red belly piranhas, what we had. We had one aquarium.
Yeah, that's the aquarium wrong.
Oops, sorry, mate.
I'm sorry.
Oh!
That's why we just kind of go slow.
Like this.
By the time we get out of this one, we'll want to eat.
There's one over there.
There's one right
there.
Here.
There was.
I see him.
There. There was one over there, Papa.
She went over to the corner, babe.
Oh, I see it.
Ain't
he's
moving.
The only one that's been swimming.
This ain't moving.
Yeah. Hey, babe, wait, babe. Well, if you come this way, that one there back there did. I don't know if you can see him in all them trees. Okay. Well, you got a picture
very
of
hard
it.
Very hard to look at.
Yeah.
Let's see if we can get to this. This one here's not doing like that other screen did. It's too vivid, it's blocking. See if it blocks or not this time. That's gonna make the blocking in again. Interested in doing something today.
Aww. I can just lay here looking at fish all day. Yeah, I can just
lie here.
Yeah. You can just lie here and push a fish.
Some of these guys are hungry. Look at their eyes opening. They seem more alive than that mess did in Atlanta.
Does it look like it's on TV to you, Dad?
they're in there. They don't move much. Look at the top, they got a fishing lure at the top of their mouth. That's how they work it. There they are.
Yeah.
Not really.
You can see his mouth.
I know, over here you can too.
Oh, he moved.
Oh, there's eyeballs right there.
I wonder where its little fishing deals that hangs out of him.
There's no fish out there, that's why. This one's just staying, that one's moving.
Yeah, they don't move much.
Why?
It's their camouflage.
Camouflage is brown and green. But I do know what you mean. It says there's three eyeballs.
Three eyeballs?
Baby flounders start out like the rest of the
world. Now let's see how it's closed.
I will say.
There are some 500 species of flatfish with eyes that blink as they move. Left to right become copper bodies. They grow up and lie down. This sneaky sideways approach usually works because flounders know that in the battle for survival, it's hard to beat. Surprise.
Thank you.
Hey, so that looks like coming in.
See it or not, I just hold my camera out and hope for the best.
Guess we could turn around and open that screen in a few seconds. First time I've seen the battery thing come up too. Big old things are moving.
There's one going along there.
I'm having a hard time seeing it.
Yeah,
can't see that one. Get in front and tell me what it is. Yeah, just go through it.
Look at the camera. Okay.
Enough to cover all the dry lands. On Earth, with a layer of salt, 520 feet deep. The Empire State Building, 1,453 feet. And then the Eiffel Tower.
This is the same. Why you don't explain it like that? Just tell me what happens here.
What happens, yeah.
Thanks, Silver. Oh!
Creating and maintaining the right aquatic environment to support sea life on a large scale is a complex task. These state-of-the-art systems clean, disinfect, and process 18,000 gallons of water per minute, over 26 million gallons a day. 13 times more water than the city of Gatlinburg uses in a day. This massive amount of water must be continuously conditioned to maintain the right levels of oxygen, salinity, and minerals, and to minimize carbon dioxide, toxic waste, and dangerous viruses and bacteria. The recipe for artificial seawater contains a host of ingredients vital to healthy seas. The most important is sodium chloride, commonly known as table salt. To achieve the right level of salinity in these terms, over 350,000 pounds of salt is added to the water.
That's the tube down there.
Yeah. See, you'll be catching from the top too.
Hi, people! Can they see me?
Sure, I don't know.
Jaws!
Finally.
But he's got like this one coming out of the same thing.
Turtle, too. It's hard to see it.
Where? Where? I don't see no turtle.
Hold on. Look, I'll show you.
Going that way. The shark was there in the middle of the water.
I don't see no turtle.
Well, he just went that way and blended in.
There's people down there.
Hi, people! And we're looking in the face.
Mom, dear.
Hi, people! Too.
Yeah.
They don't give them that much room to swim. That's me.
You can see it a little bit.
No, but I'm saying it's Done. That one's pretty right there. What are those?
Those are called parkers. No, there's one.
What are those like?
There's that.
There's that.
Like
know. You just step on it.
I know.
Well, you have to step on that.
Okay, I'm not catching up with fish. There's that one.
Why is some of them spinning?
Yeah, I see people above.
Oh, wow.
I don't.
I gotta have my eyes open so I can see too.
Yeah, just leave both eyes open. What I did say is I just pointed it. Just look, just point it and look.
What is that?
That's about the only way I've ever
experienced this. Yeah, is that like an eel?
That's an eel.
You're creepy. I mean, that's crazy.
Whoa! But I want to make sure I get it, though.
Yeah, that might turn dark on you.
It is.
We're fixing to get to the main one if we're walking via.
Did it stop?
Yeah, it stopped. We had to walk it.
Okay.
Come here, hurry up.
Some black now. Worship. We need virtual unchained. 360 million years, long before the dinosaurs. With their nine eyes, blue blood, and a mouth located at the center of a dozen mouths, horseshoe crabs aren't crabs at all. They're close relatives of spiders, ticks, and scorpions. These strange prehistoric creatures take part in one of the great mysteries of the natural world. Every spring, when the moon is full and the tides are high, thousands of horseshoe crabs return from the ocean to the shores of the bay where they were born. Like their parents before them, they return to spawn. Often, several males grab hold of a single female. The female digs a nest 6 to 8 inches deep. After she deposits her eggs, the males are pulled over the nest to fertilize them. Exactly how the crabs manage to synthesize their wives remains a mystery. But every spring, for millions of years, the appointment has been kept. And every spring, precisely the time of the horseshoe crab's peak spawning, millions of migratory shorebirds arrive. After flying thousands of miles non-stop from South America, exhausted and nearly starved, the birds stop to feast on the crab's energy-rich eggs. The eggs fuel their migration to their nesting grounds in the Arctic. Many birds nearly double their weight during this two-week feeding frenzy. After 2 weeks of spawning and gluttony, the toll seems stacked. Flipped and stranded by the surf, thousands of adult crabs perish. But their sacrifice is a gift of life, not just to their young, but to the next generation of migratory shorebirds. The surviving eggs hatch in the water. With the help of the June tide, they make their way to relatively safe, deeper waters. In 8 to 12 years, they mature. Then, in spring, when the moon is full and the tides are high, they return
I will, hold on. Because I got my camera too.
That's just wild. Look at that bad boy.
That's not enough right there.
Yeah, these right here are stonefish. They're saying light, 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 light. By the rains. So if we go through here, we find it. Does anybody feel like crab legs?
Yeah, crab legs. They're so yum.
Let's see if we can get the octopus now if he's in here.
He's supposed to be in here. Well, you can't hardly see him. He's hanging right off the back wall.
That one is. We have to look for it.
The stingray.
They spend most of their daytime and a lot of their nighttime hiding out in the cracks and crevices on either side of the exhibit, especially on the left side of the exhibit. A lot of times you can't see several of their tails just kind of hanging out over the edges of the rocks about midway back, especially if you don't want to sit there and help. But they include the Arabian bamboo sharks, the brown banded bamboo sharks, the white spotted bamboo sharks, as well as the epaulette shark. And the white spotted bamboo sharks are the middle sized of those four species. They can grow to about a foot and a half, up to about 2.5 feet long and fully grown. We also have several of those guys in here, probably around 15 to 20 of them. So it's not very rare that you don't see some of those guys out along the bottom of the exhibit just kind of scurrying around in the sand. You can actually see one sitting to the left side of the rock in the middle of the exhibit now. But the other two species of sharks are the ones you're pretty much guaranteed to see off swimming around constantly. The first of those, they look like baby hammerheads, but they are actually fully grown sharks, they're called bonnethead sharks. They are the smallest of the nine different species in the hammerhead family, not usually getting much larger than 4 to 5 feet long. And the common species of shark we have, actually the largest in the exhibit, they have the dark spots on them, looks like leopard spots. They are called leopard sharks, and they can grow to about 5 to 6 feet long fully grown. You can see one up there towards the top now. So that takes care of the animals. Now on to some of the differences between these two types of animals. And the first main difference between sharks and stingrays is the location of their gills. On the sharks, the gills are located right on the side of their head, whereas on the stingrays, they're located on the underside of their body. And the stingrays also have spiracles on the top side of their body, which are essentially just holes right behind their eyes. They act kind of like a pumping system. When the stingrays bury themselves under the sand for a long period of time, just to rest and hide from predators, the only part of their body that they will have showing are their eyes and their spiracles. They just pump the water in through those spiracles to their gills, and their gills just filter out all the oxygen from the water that they need to breathe for a long period of time, and then that excess water is just expelled through their gill slits on the underside of the body.
What's that?
Now, the second main difference between the two is a pretty obvious difference, but if you pay close attention to the way the two types of animals swim around, you'll notice that the sharks do have to use their tail to swim. They just wag it from side to side to propel them through the water. The stingrays, on the other hand, the tails have no function as far as moving the stingray around in the water. The stingrays use their pectoral fins or wings. They just alternate the movement of those wings to change the direction of the water, as well as just glide around gracefully. And the final main difference between the two is that the stingrays do have a stinging torque, which they use primarily for defense only. They do not blatantly attack anything with that stinging torque. Usually the only time they will sting another animal is if that other animal scares, startles, or threatens that stingray. And most of the time when you hear of a person getting stung by a stingray, it's because that person accidentally stepped on or landed on top of one of those stingrays because it was buried underneath the sand in shallow water or deep somewhere. And usually that person gets stung in the lower leg or the foot or something like that. All the stingrays you see in here have had their stinging barbs removed. We do that in a couple different ways. One is a surgical method, which guarantees that it will never grow back. And the other is essentially the same as clipping a fingernail. All we do is shorten the stinging barb. It grows back within about 90 days or so. We just have to clip it again. The reason we have to use a couple different methods is because one method might stress out one species of stingray more than my brother. We just have to base that on the observation of the animal when we do actually remove the water. So that takes care of the differences between the two. Mariah is going to hang around for another minute or so following the show. You're welcome to come up afterward and take some more pictures if you like. Then she's going to return over to the shallow end of Touch-A-Ray Bay. She's going to grab some more food and make a pass or two around the wall, giving everyone an excellent opportunity to touch some of those stingrays. All we ask is that you please make sure your hands wet before touching the stingrays so that you don't scratch away the protective coating on their skin. And on occasion, you might see a few sharks come close. If you see a shark swim close to you, just please pull your hand out of the water long enough to let that shark swim by without trying to touch them. The sharks are non-aggressive, they're not going to hurt you, they just do not like to even contact all the well. So just please let them swim on by, and Mariah will take care of the rest for you unless you bring the stingrays around for you. But before everyone goes into touch Ray Bay, I'd like everybody to give Mariah a hand for helping us feed these stingrays this afternoon. If you'd like to go touch the stingrays, all you do is make 3 left-handed turns or hit the ranch in the back of the room. It's the first exhibit on the left. You're on the upper level. You can't miss it. I'd like to thank everyone for hanging around for the show. I hope everyone goes to the rest of the crowd.
Five, six.
chicks and go to Mars.
Yes. Yeah.
You were going to go to Mars?
Yeah. Attraction, we're out of everything.
Battery's dead. We got 5 minutes of film left.
We got 5 minutes of film and battery's dead.
I think it's so cool. I'll just turn around and get a picture of them. Have a show while you're going to be. Please don't fall.
Hey, you can get a shot of those things real easy over there. Camera's down to the 2 minute warning. Yeah.
If you just stop, I could have snapped one. Hey, that was a good one.
Man, the battery's dead. We're down to 2 minutes of film, so we're going to have to put in a new tape.
What was the other attraction? Is it the same building, or do we have to go out?
We went through it. It was that Mars.
Oh.
If we could take it to another attraction, I'd have to go back to the room, at least turn around and get another tape, get this battery.
And let it charge up and have a smoke.
There you go. They're all just up foot with us going back.
Filming
everything.